very good morning to all of you. I am here to introduce you the another initiative which will support the distance learning lectures. Now, lectures will be offered for theory courses, but then here we are trying to help you out in your laboratory setups and laboratory experiments. So, the virtual lab is the initiative. Actually, again, it is another MHRD project under NMICT, National Mission under ICT, NME, NMEICT. So, it is basically a mission project. So, whereby we are reaching out all the students across the country who are studying engineering. So, I would like to introduce you the efforts taken by electrical department towards this. So, this is going to be the outline of my presentation. We will discuss about the objectives of this project, then the disciplines spanned by virtual labs, that is the scope of this project. I will introduce you to the virtual labs at IIT Bombay, electrical department, IIT Bombay. Then we will have the different labs offered by our labs, our Wadhwani electronics lab, where we will have our lab sessions. Then we will see what IIT Bombay can offer you, how we support you to help your laboratories. Then how you implement certain things in your institutes, so your role basically, and what we expect from you. So basically, this virtual lab project was started to help all the engineering colleges across the country. As I said before, all the engineering colleges may not have good resources in terms of manpower as well as the infrastructure. Some colleges will have very good facilities, and it is a very good idea to share these resources. So basically, the main purpose of this virtual lab is to share the resources by giving the remote access to the various disciplines of engineering. There is no point in just giving you the procedure of a particular experiment, because basically we are targeting the students. Anyway, the students are going to be the users of this facility. So we expect the student to perform the experiment with some basic background given to him. So we will provide all the necessary theory which is required to perform any experiment. Now, just by providing theory and the procedure, like how we have our lab sheets, that is also not enough, because in a, normally even in IIT also students perform in groups. So in a group here we have the group of three students. So in the group of three students, two students are active and the third one is not that active for various reasons. Maybe he is a slow learner, he is not having enough confidence, and as a result, since that third person is weak, he becomes weaker and weaker when he works with smarter counterparts. So here, by some means, we would like to help such people who are weak, who are not confident, so they can learn at their own pace. So even after, during the lab, if the student is not comfortable, can go back, he can log on to the system here, he can perform the experiment or understand the concepts as his or her own pace. So this is very important. So with this remote lab, students can learn the basic and advanced concepts at their own pace. Now, this is a big project. The participating institutes are almost all IITs, and there are some, that is Amrita University, the Yalbagh Institute, and College of Engineering, Pune. So they have huge contribution towards this project, and if I am not wrong, we are using the front end made by them for our website. Now, as we say that we are helping all engineering students, these are the disciplines spanned by virtual labs all over India. So we are catering to all these disciplines, and the first three disciplines are the ones of our interest. We will be helping out the students from electronics and communication, electrical engineering and computer science, because all these have something in common, that is electronics. We are catering to most of the electronics laboratories. And there are mechanical engineering, chemical engineering, biomedical, civil, physical sciences, and so on. Now the labs we are offering from Wadhwani Electronics Lab of IIT Bombay. Now actually this project started 2 years ago as a pilot phase, in which the ministry asked the participating institutes to come out with the hardware triggered, remote triggered laboratories. The IITs and participating institutes were successful in developing those experiments which are triggered remotely. But the problem with that is the scaling up issue. You cannot reach all the students, because when you have a remote triggered lab, only one user can access it at a time. So scaling up issue was very important to reach out maximum number of students. So ministry thought that in order to reach more number of students, let us have something which is not actually the experiment, but then which will give the students feel of performing experiment actually. So they came up with simulation based laboratories, wherein there is no limit on the number of students accessing the laboratories. So here at IIT Bombay, Wadhwani Lab, IIT Bombay, we are offering all sorts of laboratories. That is, we have some simulation based labs, we have some remote triggered labs, and this is the third category. It is not virtual. There is nothing virtual or there is nothing remote in this. This is a low cost development kit which is produced here. The problem with this, why we went for this kind of laboratory, is though we say that now in India you can have access to internet at any place, but that is not the reality. You have internet access, but at the same time you don't have power, and vice versa. So the students will have problems in accessing internet, so web-based labs. So we came out with a small board, low-cost board, which we will be distributing to the institutes, and the students can work without any necessity of the internet access. So this is another effort, and I'm very happy to inform you that you are going to be the first users of this third lab, the digital design using CPLD board. So we will be having sessions based on this CPLD based labs, and we will be giving you the boards, these low cost boards, so that you can set up some experiments at your end. We have experiments set up based on this board, but we can always add up the number of experiments. Now here is the architecture of the DSP lab. The DSP lab that we have is a remote triggered lab. Basically, actually, for all these labs, the learning is in three steps. First is the theory which we are providing. Theory will have, actually it is not ready today, but then it will have the interactive tutorials based on applets. So then students always think, given a circuit, when they come to the laboratory, we have a set pre-configured experiment. They connect the circuit, they test the circuit, and then they get the readings, and then that's it. They will not have any chance to vary the parameters and say, what if I vary this particular component, what if I vary the transistor of some other beta, and so on. They don't have opportunity to do that. And even if they have opportunity, every time it is not possible practically to try out all these things. So basically we will have it in three steps. First step is to give them the basic theory understanding. Then by using the applets, they will vary the parameters, and they will see the effect of varying the parameters without any circuit requirement of any laboratory or circuit connections. Here now, by now they will be comfortable, they are expected to be comfortable with the concept. Then the next step is simulation. Again, you don't have to go to the laboratory. The student can do all these things at home whenever he has free time. The simulation based labs all the simulation based labs are based on the simulation software, either which is freely available or public domain. The next session we are going to have the session based on simulation. So students can try out their own circuits, simulate and see what happens by actually connecting the circuit, and they can have a feel of experiment. Now once they have simulations, then they are expected to have the their level of confidence going up. And now the third step is to perform the experiment either in your lab or by having the hardware triggered experiment at our end. Now the lab which is ready now today, it is DSP lab. This is the architecture. The basic requirement of this DSP lab from your end is just a computer with internet access. The student writes the program. Are there anybody from DSP background? Very good. So, but anyway, it is basically everybody has used microcontrollers, microprocessors. So basically, it is the experimental procedure is basically the same. You write the program, compile it, and then you burn it on the processor, and then you work with it. So the student from remote end writes the program, sends the binary file here. The processor will be programmed here, which is sitting in IIT Bombay. Once the processor is programmed, if you are writing the program for say a kind of filter, now once the processor is programmed, now what you have to do is you have to just vary the input signal and see the output if you are working on a filter. The necessary instrumentation, the DSP board, everything is sitting here. The student has access to all the instruments which are required, not only the access but even the control. So sitting there, the student can control the function generator and vary the value, vary the parameters of the input signal, and immediately in real time the student is able to see the effect, that is the output at his end on his user interface. So that is how the basic system is. And same thing will be true for even the other labs which we are proposing and you will be having in near future. Of all the courses, in my previous slide, the labs which were simulation based, we are planning to have all the labs which can be remotely triggered. Now coming to the architecture of this DSP lab. So basically this is the workstation over here. We will have, right now we have just one set, but we will have, in future we will have several sets like this. So this is the DSP kit sitting here, then function generator and oscilloscope. This is the basic instrumentation required for the DSP lab. So there will be several such stations connected through internet, and these are the users, user 1, user 2 and so on. So what you do is you have a remote server, remote lab server, which is capable of authenticating and load balancing, because at a time we expect several users. So depending upon the request, this server will put you on the free hardware. So all this arrangement has been done. So, and then tomorrow we will be having a demonstration, short demonstration of this lab. This is a sample lab which is ready. Most of the universities have signals and systems course, and this is the course offered at, if I am not wrong, at the second year level or maybe third year level, depending upon the university. Students often find the concepts very difficult to understand because there is nothing which they can really see. So it is very difficult for the students to understand this signals concepts. So here in this lab, again, as I told you, it is basically a three-level approach. First is theory. Now here in this case, there is no hardware involved. So there is no actual experiment because it is basically the theory. But then though this is not offered as a lab course in most of the universities, here our approach is to help the theory course. Here we are taking the measures in best possible way to help all the courses taught in the colleges. So we will provide all the material which is necessary. as I said before, the software requirements from the user end, we will try to use as far as possible open source software. So that's why here Scilab. As somebody said, asked me yesterday, like, you in such workshops, people get to know about some new software, but then when they go back, again, it is a problem for them to recollect and try it out. So that problem is solved here. All the material will always be available on the website all the time. So even if you forget some things, you go back and refer, all the necessary help will be provided. And not only just the help in the form of text, here we have provided the video tutorials also, right from how to download the software till you how to use it. So all the necessary step-by-step instructions for using the software, for writing the programs and executing them, everything is provided. Then one important thing is the pre-session and post-session test. This is basically just for self-evaluation. If you have some set of questions, the students feel a little more confident when they are able to answer those questions. So basically the test is just for self-evaluation. Now, as I said, DSP lab. Now, since we are catering to the entire, students community, all different universities will have different curriculum, different processes they will have for study. So now basically our system is independent of processor. But right now we are providing you with two processors, processor kits from TI, that is DSK5510 and DSK6713. Another approach to reach out more number of people is the development of a low cost DSP board using TMS320 VC33. This board has been developed here at IIT Bombay, and we will have this particular board for assembly level programming. Often what happens is students either write programs in MATLAB or in C, and they will not be able to appreciate why was the need of making a DSP processor, whereas the microcontrollers were available. So unless they know the assembly level programming, unless they know the architecture of the processor, they will not be able to appreciate the need for going for processor. So here we have introduced this VC33 board to give them the insight to their assembly level programming, architectural concepts and things like that. This is the setup here at our lab. You can see the oscilloscope. This is this is the interface which actually the user will see. This is the oscilloscope, and you can see it almost looks like the real oscilloscope. This is the function generator. This is also almost a replica of the front panel of this function generator. This is the DSP kit. This is what the user sees at his user interface. So here the user uploads binary file. From here we have given some sample programs. They can try ready-made programs. Then we will ask them to try out some more programs for their, they can write their own programs for different coefficients of filter or whatever. And then they program the DSP, and then you have the control over both the instruments. This is the DSP lab, which is available. Now, support from IIT Bombay. Very important thing is that the students will have free access. Nothing will be charged, and you are not supposed to charge the students when you allow your students to use this facility. So updates about the current development, because today the all the labs are not ready. As and when we have the experiments ready, we will upload them on the website, and then we will inform you. Then we will conduct such workshops, and we will inform you to participate in these workshops and seminars. Since we cannot have syllabi from all the universities, we will welcome your suggestions to include new experiments. And now, who has developed this all these labs? It is the students who are studying here, and the students who come here for summer internship. The board which you will be getting tomorrow, that was developed by one of the summer interns and one of our students. So we welcome your students to be summer interns and work for this virtual lab, because as you see, it has got huge number of labs to offer. So we welcome your students. The only requirement is they should work here very hard. They should take maximum benefit of these resources, and then they can make wonders. Now, what is your role? Who is the actual user? The actual user is the students, and we are the developers. So here, the developers means we, and the users will be the students. But then, if we give the random access, then we will not know, and we will not be able to make use of the facility to fullest. So, if we have the understanding between you and us, then we can work better. So, you are going to be the interface between us and the students, so we can work through you. Now, as a nodal center, what you can do is you can suggest new experiments, as I said before, because if you have some problems in setting up the experiment at your end, you can ask us, we can work together, and we can include new experiments. And then, since this is a mission project, encourage the use of virtual labs by spreading awareness. That is what we are here for. So, awareness among faculty. Why faculty? Because, as again somebody pointed out yesterday, when some new faculty joins, this lab is going to be very helpful for a new faculty who joins without any background. So, if you have some basic reference material, the person can set up new experiments and things like that. So, faculty, and even another thing is that how faculty is going to get benefited. During your lectures, you log on. Yesterday's experiment, simple experiment, diode characteristic, no problem. The transistor characteristic, while explaining to the class, if you log on to our system, the actual experiment will be running here. You can show how the characteristics look like, how you find out H parameters from the characteristics. You can easily show all these things. So, that way it is going to help the students. The interactive tutorials, that will help you to explain the concepts to the students. So, this is not just helpful for the students, but as well as for the teachers as teaching aids. Because I am sure that even if we have 5 sets, you cannot replace your traditional labs, and you should not. Our effort is not to replace the traditional labs. They have to work with their hand, they have to solder and burn their fingers. No, they have to do all that. But to do that, let them have some better understanding, and that is why these labs are for. So, then your role as nodal center, so what do you have to do is, first thing is set up the facility at your end with 10 pieces with broadband at least 1 Mbps. I am sure all the colleges have this much facility. Now, since we have developed this, we have not yet launched. Today, we are launching our website. So, it will be available to all of you. I am sure there will be many bugs because it has not been tested. So, you let us know our errors, bugs. So, that way you can help us in field testing, gathering end user feedback. How do students feel? End users are the students. How do they feel? How do they, what all things they would expect more? So, all this feedback is encouraged. Then popularize the use of virtual lab. And then put your best foot forward to contribute to this mission project. We can work out together. So this is all about the labs offered at IIT Bombay here. So this is the virtual labs at Electronics IIT Bombay. I will just quickly have it, because tomorrow anyway we will be having a demo session in our lab. But just before that, if you get free time in the evening, it will be very difficult actually, because we have one more evening session today. But anyway, let me introduce you. So, basically this is the home page. This is all about the virtual lab. These are the various labs we are offering. And then let us have a quick visit to all these labs. So, devices and circuits, electronic devices and circuits lab. Here, right now we have the list of experiments which are expected to be worked using simulation tool, and SQL is the simulation tool which you will be using for all these four labs, and in 5 minutes you will start working with SQL. You have electronic devices. I'm sure this is the part of all basic electronics labs. So, and this is the experiment which you are going to perform today in the morning session. Anyway, let us not worry. The handout has been given to you yesterday itself. Then we have electronic circuits lab, in which you will be performing biasing circuits using BJT. And this is the list of experiments. Maybe we can definitely modify this list depending upon your needs. Then we'll have network analysis lab. By the way, let me tell you that we have got this project approved only in December on the simulation based labs. So very few experiments are ready right now. But then I'm sure during this summer we can come up with more number of experiments. And this is the linear integrated circuits lab. That is what the course is taught in many universities, the op-amp based subject. So these are the experiments we will be performing during this workshop. Then we have this modern digital design using CPLD and FPGA. Both the labs, I mean both the courses are part of the electronics curriculum in most of the universities. So we will be offering you these labs. CPLD labs I will not need not show you, because anyway you will be using that, and FPGA is getting ready soon. Then signal processing lab, as I mentioned some time back, it is the signal processing means here you are we are offering you signals and system and DSP. Then we will also be having image processing. Yes, I'm sure no university has image processing as a core course in their curriculum. This is offered as one of the electives, but yet it will help the theory. So this is the list of experiments. All are simulation based experiments. So soon we will be having that. Then microcontrollers, we have not yet started working on that, for the reason it is the easiest course students usually find. So we are just thinking of providing the laboratory for all platforms. If the students want 8051, yes, get started with 8051. So we will have a setup for 8051. If they want AVR, yes, we will have the solutions for AVR. So right from 8051 up to ARM, we have the plans to, like, you know, give you all the getting started material, because all the resources are, yes, available at almost all the places. So this is the plan for microcontrollers lab. So with this, I hope this lab will be helpful. Yeah.